Hey, this is Pastor Frank, and I want to share with you a verse that is not so prevalent in our modern church. The one that is supremely prevalent, of course, is John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his beloved Son, that whoever would believe in him may not perish but have everlasting life. And so we come up with the mantra, and it's a good mantra. Jesus died for my sins. Jesus laid down his life for my sins so that I could go to heaven. Wonderful. But now what do we do? Well, corresponding to John 3:16 is a verse called 1 John 3:16, where it picks up on that thought. In this love was manifested, that he laid down his life for us. And then John adds these words, so then, purpose clause, result, natural byproduct, we ought also to lay down our lives for the brethren. Those are our marching orders until he returns. Just as Jesus laid down his life for us, so we lay down our lives for others. Why does this have to happen? Well, so that others can enter into the love, so that others can go into heaven. 1 John 4 declares that people have never seen God, but they can see the love that we have and then find God. Paul put it this way, we are the living letters from God, telling the world how much God loves them. Ours is an other-centered faith. We focus not just on what we receive, but how God through us can allow others to receive as we lay down our lives. You might want to memorize those two verses and put them together. I think it's fascinating that they both carry chapter 3, verse 16. It's almost like the Holy Spirit was saying, don't miss this one. Jesus died for your sins is a wonderful message, but complete the message by laying down your life for others. Bless you and have a wonderful day.